Ozone is the new Joey from Bread.
Greetings and welcome to Friday's Ozone, which a little later on, of course, features our regular Friday video vote. But first, another Ozone exclusive. Paul McCartney and I having a bit of a natter.
Did I ever take you in my arms, look you in the eye, tell you that I do? Did I ever open up my heart, let you look inside? If I never did it, I was only waiting for a better moment that didn't come. There never could be a better moment than this one. This one, this one is lighting above the ocean. A god is riding upon his back. How calm the water and bright the rainbow, fade this one to black.
There's one thing I've always wanted to ask somebody as mega famous as you in the pop world, Paul, and that's like, when you were a kid, did you stand in front of a mirror with a hairbrush and mime to records?
I still do.
Did you mime to records when you were a kid?
Yeah, definitely, yeah. First thing you used to do was try and get the Elvis lip, which was the Cliff Richard lip, the singer. And that was like, definitely took a little bit of bathroom mirror work to accomplish that one. Yeah, you know, I think all kids are the same. You kind of used to look in front of the mirror and sort of try and look like, which is my best side? Because I still don't know to this day.
If I never did it, I was only waiting for a better moment that didn't come. There never could be a better moment than this one, this one, this one.
Did you have a summer job or a Saturday job when you were a kid?
I had a paper round.
How much did you get paid for that?
Well, it was, I don't know, it was like 50p for the round. But, you know, it's the same old story. It was quite good money then. It was more than you got in pocket money. It was a bit more than your pocket money, so you kind of doubled your pocket money and a bit plus. And it was good. I liked it for the independence of, you know, sort of getting out and at that young age sort of working in a proper job. I didn't like the dogs I met along the way. That's a bit of a hazard.
What opportunities did we allow to flow by? Feeling like the timing wasn't quite right. What kind of magic might have worked if we'd stayed calm? Couldn't I have given you a better life?
I think it's going to be difficult for James. I mean, growing up as the son of probably one of the most famous men in the world.
Well, of course, it's difficult, you know, but...
what do you do?
Linda and I have always lived knowing that that was a big danger with our kids. So we've always... They all go to state schools, because the idea being that if we can get them to be kids with their feet on the ground, that when they then get a little bit more sort of, whatever it is, richer or famous, whatever, they get older, they'll be able to deal with all types of people. Instead of if they go to a very posh school, I find sometimes you tend to look down on people. Oh, yes, it's the milkman. You know, which I don't like.
Did you ever take me in your arms, look me in the eye, and tell me that you do? Did I ever open up my heart, let you look inside?
A bloke talked to me after the Toxteth riots that they had a few years ago, and he said, you know, it'd be great for Liverpool. He said, a fame school, as he called it. And, I thought it really would be a good idea for kids across the board, no matter how much wealth they had in the families.
There's a lot of native talent in Liverpool.
There's still a lot of talent there. So asked the people through the local newspaper if there was any interest, because I didn't want to get involved with it and go pouring my heart out.
Yeah,
and
you presumably kept your involvement fairly low key at the beginning.
Well, I just basically said to people through the newspaper, do you want this thing or not? If you do, I'll work really hard to try and accomplish it, but there's no sense me working hard if you don't want it. And they had a lot of very positive response. Millions of people, thousands of people, I should say, rang in and said, yeah, it would be a good idea. So it's going to take a long time, but maybe in a few years' time, we'll have the finest performing arts school in the world.
I never did it. I was only waiting. was only waiting for a better moment that didn't come. There never could be a better moment than this one, this one.
The new video that's very reminiscent of your time in the 1960s. Now, was that your idea, or was that the video director?
He said, have you got any ideas? And I said, yeah, and unfortunately he listened to me. The idea of the song is that this moment is the moment to concentrate on instead of worrying about the past or the future. So that reminded me of this kind of very Indian sort of meditative thing. And he liked the idea. So we decided to try and make a video where most of the video we've got our eyes closed. And then he painted the eyes on the top there. That's that sort of freaky look.
Did you ever take me in your arms, look me in the eye, and tell me that you do?
I once had these leather trousers that were in the auction. And I said, wait a minute, I never gave my leather trousers away. They said, well, you better come down and check them. So there's this scene with me in this lawyer's office, awfully serious, checking out this terrible pair of leather kecks. And I said, they're not mine. He said, well, are you sure? You swear to this fact? I mean, it does get a bit ridiculous sometimes. Still, you know, so does life.
Paul McCartney, one of the nicest men in rock and roll, and that was him talking exclusively to the Ozone. Now then, of course, it's Friday, and if you've been watching the Ozone over the last week, you will have seen the four videos. We'd like you to vote for your favourite.